Oh, hello. Jim Howard here in Fort Worth, Texas. Today's date, it is October 28th of 2016. I'm using my Blue Yeti microphone for this video. And of course, I'm using the Logitech C930E USB webcam for the video. I think I'll be showing you a little bit on the screen. A little video I made the other night of Hillary and Stripey, it's a feral cat, but in the house now for the next 7 days because Hillary took it to have it fixed and it has to post-operative, has to be watched. But I made it with this camera. This is the Panasonic, and you'll see that video at the end of whatever I'm going to do here, with the Panasonic LX7. This is a great little camera. Of course, now they have the LX10, I think it is. And I haven't used this very much. It's a great camera, especially for low light. It's just a great camera. But you know, I always want a better camera, a different camera. I've been interested in photography from when I was in grade school. But I love digital. Oh man, that was so, back in the old days with the film. But my favorite camera, let's see, my favorite camera, where is my browser here? Google search. Twin lens reflex camera. Is that correct? Yeah. Of course, I did not have a Rolex. I had a, you know, the inexpensive, well, probably like this one here, $35 camera. Well, no, I didn't. That looks like an older, really older one. But I love to make a better view of a twin lens. Maybe Wikipedia has a better. Okay, this is, well. Okay, this is more like it, I think. This is not the one I had. But you look down, it was 120 or 240 film. And you looked down, and it was a square format. And I just loved it. What did I do? Did I close the browser? I did. Okay, let me open this back up. There is a wish list, excuse me, just belched it. This is my wish list. Some of the things I just put on here to, you know, the Fire TV stick is really looking good, $40. Like I have ham radio things on this wish list for Amazon. You do not want to buy them. You want to get them at Gigaparts or a ham radio site, because they're way too expensive. But I put them on there to remember. I have one of these ultra wide TVs or monitors. I'd kind of like to get this 29 inch, and I'm not sure what, if this is a 22 inch or, well, I think, I don't know if you measure the ultra wide 30. No, not centimeters, 12. 23 inch. Well, no, that's along the bottom. I don't know. I'd kind of like to have this, but also I had a Chromebook, if you remember, and I really hated the Chromebook. But this one here has 4 gigabytes of memory, and it has a touch screen, and it folds into a tablet. And now, of course, with the Chromebooks, the new ones, I'm not sure what they're going to do about the old ones, they support not just the Google App Store, but they support the Android App Store. And this is $269. Oh, man. I'm looking at my how much money I have available. This is for this camera that I have here. This has this Panasonic, which is extra viewfinder, slides in here. And I was going to buy it the other day. I've had it on my list for since I got this camera, whenever that was, because I had a Panasonic camera before this that I sold to my son at a discount, and it had the digital viewfinder built in, and oh man, fantastic viewfinder, and for taking photos outside in the sun, fantastic. This is the same, except it's an addition to this one, and I've had it on my wish list for, well, since I got this, whenever that was. And it ranged in price from like, I think, $130 to $150. So the other last week or whatever, I thought, okay, I'm going to get this. And I go there, and I usually end up checking my wish list like every day, adding things to it and whatever, jogging my memory. And I went there, and it had gone up to $206. And I thought, no, I'm not going to do it. It's been for a year more. $130 is most $150, I'm just not going to do it. I went to eBay and did a search, and supposedly a guy had one that was brand new, but the box wasn't. And I don't think it was brand new, but apparently probably took it, you know, he hadn't used it very much at all, if any. So he wanted, I think, buy it now, $124. And he said it had a thing where you could make an offer. So I made him an offer of $100. And he just listed it. And I said, I'll pay you $100. And bang, immediately somebody did the buy it now for $124. And I thought, why in the world didn't I just pay him the $100, do the buy it now, $124? So now, anyway, back to this wish list, because it jogs my mind about a lot of things to tell you about. If you're watching, okay, if you're watching, on the back of this, you can see I'm watching Twit. It's reflected from over there. I'm watching the Twit Apple October event from yesterday. And if you watch down here on the screen, I was a early adopter, or when they were beta or whatever, of EM client, which is like Outlook Express for email. And I think I donated money, and but what they just did a release or whatever, and it's really nice. And I pay for Outlook Express, I think I'm paying for Office, and that's included or something like that. I don't pay very much, but I pay it monthly. And this is now better, but I don't want to I have to look through my records and see if I can find, because I can't find it. I couldn't find even an email in the Google Gmail search. But I think I paid for it, and so I don't know if there's a code or something. Really, I'm going to check that out. But anyway, I would like to have this ultra-wide monitor. But I would like to also, I'd like to get that Chromebook, because it'll fold over to a tablet mode, and I could really, that'd come in handy. And I think the one I had before was 2 gigabytes, I believe. And this is 4 gigabytes. But, okay. Welcome, Rusty. Please don't rub your ass on my glass of Coke. Don't knock over anything, please. Oh, this thing that keeps popping up here. I went into the settings for e-client or email, whatever this, what is this called? EM client. And I cannot figure out how to turn off that, because I don't, but I'll figure it out eventually. I have one of these security key, not this exact, well, I have a security key like this, which I never use. In fact, I don't know where it is now. Now this this monitor here, I bought a few, I like think I bought it last month, and I had it for one day. It has fantastic audio, believe it or not. I know monitors are not supposed to have good. It has Asus Sonic Master Technology, co-developed with Bang and Olufsen, ICE Power for premium immersed audio. And also, when I hooked it up, the audio came through right to the speakers on the monitor without me having to use a 3.5 audio. It came through, and it was good. But my grandson, although he has, I don't know how many monitors and giant screen TV in his room and whatever, he actually needed a monitor. And so I just gave him the monitor when I got it, the same day I got it. But one reason, just for that audio, I'm thinking of, and that was less, see, that's 234. What was the price of, I'm thinking of buying another one. That's so stupid of me, though. Well, let me show you the, now let me go back to this list, because it jogs my Alexa shopping list. That's a new thing on the list here. Anyway, back to my wish list. Oh, like I said, I have this. This is a really neat one of these computers that's the size of it, you know, for $189. Comes with Windows 10 built in. Wow. Oh, here's the. Well, I'm not sure this is on my list now. But I'd like to have, I think this is used prices, because it's $263. I think it's a used price. But it's a Canon EOS M, 18 megapixel. But it does fantastic video. And I'd like to have that, but where is the camera? Hopefully I have it on the wish list. Hopefully I'm going to show it to you and you're going to order one for me. It is, I probably took it off because it was just, yeah, I think I took it off. I forget what model, but the way Amazon works, when I go someplace, it will pop up, but it, I think it's the LX100, is it? But it has an articulating LCD screen, but it just folds up so you can do selfies, which is what I really need. And it also folds down, which would be looking, I'd be looking down through, like, you know, like in the old days when I was using my twin lens reflex. I'd really like to have the camera for that reason, but I think it's $600 or $800. Can't remember now which one it was. I took it off my list because I just knew it was too much. This reminds me, I had to borrow one from a neighbor today. My ex-wife, who lives next door, and she has or had a 40-inch TLC television for 5 years. It started for the last couple weeks doing strange things. I went over a few times. It would pop up a menu to make some changes. It would delete from her list of channels a couple of the channels that she needed to switch to game input or television, over-the-air television. Then it would just start changing channels like crazy. And I went over, and it's a mess over there with stuff she has hooked up to, or had hooked up to it, and with cables on the floor, and it, I got arthritis bending over and unplugging something, whatever. I couldn't figure out what the problem was. And sometimes it would go for 24 hours and not have that problem. I kind of thought that maybe somebody had a remote control, a universal remote control that happened to occasionally key up and do something they didn't intend, you know, something they were doing something else, but because of the code, it also did, well, I don't know, but she just decided to order a new television. So she got a TLC, she got it today. Well, I see it's after midnight, so she got it yesterday. She got a TCL 48 inch. And the UPS guy delivered today. I was out there and I saw him pull in. And I had it shipped by Prime, to, you know, it was coming to me. But I thought, if I catch him, I'm going to have him, when he brings it to my door, she lives next door, and I'll just say, please drop it here, you know. So I saw him pull in the gate down there at the apartment complex. And I thought, oh, great. So I just stand out here by my apartment, and when he comes around to drop it off, I'll just have him, you know, drop it there. Save him some steps, actually. And then I saw him a little bit later driving out the gate, and I knew what he'd done. He'd taken all his UPS packages and dropped them off the office. So I borrowed this, and Hillary went with me, and we went down and loaded on there. And she was going to help me push it back up, and she had her cell phone with her, and she got a business call. So I'm pushing it back by my, you know, she's doing her business call. She can't, when she's logged in for her business call, she can't not take a call. She gets into trouble and they penalize her or whatever. I need to buy one of these, but the guy I borrowed this from, I told him, I'm going to buy one of those. And he said he either got it for $20 or $40 from Lowe's or someplace like that. But after the price has come down here, it was $86, I think. Or, anyway, Anyway, she got her television, and it's a Roku. It's a 48-inch Roku. And she tried my, I have what you're saying on the back of here. I'm not sure how big it is. It's not very big. It's a Roku TV, but it looks nice in here because of the short distance. So she'd been using, we have another television set that has a Roku 2 device. And I had loaned her the Roku TV, or the Roku, my television and the Roku device. And so she liked Roku. But so now we ended up with her 40-inch 5-year-old TV. Have that in the living room, and I hooked up my, now when I got it, I got my back, my Roku device, hooked that up in there. So we have, for the first time in the living room, a big screen to, 40-inch big screen. Maybe that's not considered big screen now, biggest screen now, but it looks nice in there, because before the television set that was in there was this one here, and Hillary sitting in the big chair could watch that in there. But if somebody wanted to sit on the couch, the sofa, or whatever, and watch it, it would be, the screen was too small. Now we could go in, we could watch a movie, together, some, maybe a pay-per-view movie. Oh, okay, I was going to, and I'm gonna come back here, going to show you the video that I made of Hillary and the cat. And the cat is a feral cat that Hillary has made friend. Hillary has paid to have a male cat neutered, and he was a problem around here. A nice, well, not real friend, but she tamed him. People couldn't believe it here that he'd been a wild cat around here and getting other cats all pregnant. And Hillary tamed him, where he fought, she, he follows her around. Well, he shouldn't have followed her around, because she took him and paid to have him fixed. And then a female cat that she got rid of, the Hillary found people to take the kittens. She took it and had it fixed, and it had to stay inside for 6 days. And then this other cat had kittens, and when the kittens were given away, Hillary took her a couple of days ago to get her fixed, and she has to stay in here for a total of 6 days. And Hillary had to pay for all of these things, have a vet do it. But here's the cat that she just had fixed, and hopefully Hillary is not going to have. But so this is a feral cat that we have in here. In the last night or two, it's been crying at once outside. Hillary put it in the thing, and, well, you'll see, took it outside and sat outside with it and whatever. Tonight it's being kind of quiet, but here's Hillary, and this video was made with this Panasonic. I want a new camera. It doesn't matter. Well, it does matter. I know it doesn't matter. I like cameras. And there's always, the problem is, there's always, well, I can't afford really, really expensive camera. There's always, this is a really good camera, it has some really nice features, but then there are some other cameras. And I see that, I think I want that because of that. But here's Hillary. Not sure if I'll get the audio right here. I should put the headphone in this thing so I can monitor the audio.
Thank you. Is that Jim? It's Grandpa. Hey, Grandpa. Hey, Grandpa. He's filming you. He says, I want to be with you.
Yes, yes, here you are. I'm in a little cage.
You want in your new outfit? You dress your own, or do you want to be in the bed?
This one wants out. Okay. Yeah, we'll go see Dora. That's a good idea.
Yeah, I cleaned it. It's all seen everything.
And I washed it. Okay. Are you ready?
She's ready. She got in. She wants to go see the water.
Okay. We're back. I've been playing this. This is Caesar's Slots Free Casino. I've spent a little bit of money because you can buy, well, it shows us dollars, but it's not, you know, not, it's, but dollars. You can buy money to play, and I've ended up spending a little bit of money. I shouldn't spend any at all because I don't normally do that, but I had I think $4 million the other day, $4 million other bucks, and that it was a new game that became available. I clicked on that and I was doing something else, and I clicked about four times, and it was set to bet $1 million. And I, what happened? Bang, it was gone. So anyway, let's play this. This is I forget what it's called. Just $183,000. I'm betting $12,500. The doubloons, if you get five, you don't necessarily win anything. If you get six or more, and you could get up to 10, I think it is, you can win some big bucks. Oh, good. Free spins. It's Moby Dick is what it is. Got a pill in my mouth. If you link it with Facebook, then your Facebook picture here or whatever shows up. Okay, I guess I can do the double. This is not smart, but
select red or black to play. Play up to three rounds.
Okay. Should I take red or black?
Black win. Two rounds remaining.
Oh man, this is not smart. I've actually done this in a real casino for real money. And one time, Hillary was with me and Jimmy were with me, and we had both blown, I think we came to, we did $100 each or whatever, and I was down to, and basically nothing, but the slot machine had a, you know, a few coins left. And I did this, and so I was doing this thing, and I won like five, you know, I clicked and I won, okay, let's take her, you know, and Hillary and Jimmy, no, no, go on. I went on about five times and I won, and we all had a bunch of money again, and we went out, lost it. I mean, you know, black or red?
Black wins. Last round.
Oh no, I'm stopping. Too bad we can't, So anyway, they have a contest that goes on. I'm number eight. I like the fact that you can see these people's pictures. Let me do this. I'm gonna click, hold it down here. I'm just gonna do 10, so it's gonna do it 10 times hands-free. You didn't even give me, oh, that's what I was gonna, I'll tell you in a minute. I'm a diabetic, by the way. What I don't like about it is because it's linked by to Facebook. When I have a big win or something, it'll say, do you want to post that to your Facebook? And there's a button you can opt out. Sometimes it does so fast you can't hit the button and it gets posted. So if you go look at my Facebook, let's go look at my Facebook. You're gonna see those things in there. Well, let me go to my feed. I took this 22 questions on the American system of government or whatever, and of course I got all 22 correct, and except for a couple, I really, and of course you had multiple choice, except for a couple, I could have got them all correct without having multiple choice. I could have just said, you know, what the answer was. But for a couple of them having to do, I think one was the total number of U.S. members of the House of Representatives. And I wasn't, I knew like 500 and something, but I wasn't sure. But by then seeing the numbers that they had, like four choices, you know. And then another, the other one was if I just had to come up with a number, I'd have probably missed it. The other was, how many amendments are there and to the Constitution? And there I wouldn't have known, and I forget what the number was now, 27 or 29, or I think it was 29. But by looking, having a multiple choice, you know, it says like 11. Well, we know there's the Bill of Rights, the 10 amendments, first 10 amendments, and we know there's, you know, more than 11. And whatever the, and the other, I think, was 99 or something, and I knew that wasn't it, so. But I got all these correct. When President Kennedy announced the Peace Corps, I immediately contacted him and said I wanted to volunteer for the Peace Corps. And so I was the first, one of the first people to take the Peace Corps exam in the United States, but the first person, you know, one of the first group in Kansas City for sure. And I aced the test. Unbelievable. But the test was, it was almost like if they'd have said, Jim, design a test for yourself about, you know, for the Peace Corps about, you know, and I mean, all the things, I just looked at it, oh my God, and of course, it was pretty amazing. I did not end up going with the Peace Corps. I might have told that story. If not, someday I'll tell you why. Let's see. Okay, here's the type of thing that pops up. I don't want it to pop up, but there's not an option. The only option for me would be to opt out of the thing on Facebook. And I do like the fact that my picture shows up. Let's do 10 more. Let's up the bet since I've got $6 million. Let's up bet the thing to $25,000. And let's do 10 again. When you bet $25,000, your money goes down quick. Okay. Nothing. $80,000 winning. They have other game, you know. Let's see, this is an app, so is this from the, this is from the Windows Play Store, I think. Moby Dick's what I've been playing. There's this. Just gonna do this a couple times to show it to you. One more time after this. Back to the lobby. Okay. Up this to 25,000. We're going to do 10 with this. Thank you. big win. Maybe you people are lucky for me. Let me know if you actually want to want me to continue playing this on camera sometimes. Actually, I could do it live. We could do a live streaming. I don't know if you maybe not be interested at all. I'd rather play yourself. Let me go to, I'm going to shut this down. Let me go to the, no, I don't need to go there. I can go over here to the Google Play Store. Let's see. What in heck did I call that? Here it is. So it's in the Google Play Store. And it's free. See, that's why I'd like to. I wonder if you could make a donation. Let me go to YouTube and go to my channel. Patreon, I don't even have set up. Let's see, Google. Okay, here it is at the top. If you happen to be at my channel, you can click on donate via PayPal and go right there and donate some money. So if you want to do that, let me go to Amazon, or if you want to go to my Amazon wish list, what am I looking for? Amazon. Let's see, wish list. Want to donate? If you want to donate, I think I would buy right now this Asus $269. I think I would buy it. I've seen all the reviews of it on YouTube, and I think now I would be happier with it. 4 gigabytes, and that it's a touch screen, and the fact that now not just the Google apps are available, but the I think this is pretty neat. I didn't set it up this way, but you can see on the back of my TV set, or on back of this monitor, you can see what I'm watching over there. I'm a genius, right? But anyway, if you want to go to my wish list and if you go to my wish list, how do you do that on Amazon? I don't know. I've forgotten. I have forgotten. But anyway, this gets fantastic reviews. And but remember, of course, I had one. But if I didn't, if you donate money also on my wish list, I don't know about this wide ultra wide, because I was saying this one is really wide that I have, this other one, but well, probably this, but you know, I want a camera, which, how come it doesn't show me? I took all those off because they were just too much money. Well, this is one, but it does not have, this one is, oh, and that's not the price, by the way. Okay, see, it shows here that it's $263. If it was $260, okay, let me add this to my wish list. Okay, now I'll go to my wish list, and there it is. It's $593 to $649, because that was for, and it doesn't show up there, that was for some reason used. And I just don't want to buy a used camera. But it's a really nice camera, but it's not the one. Which one was it? But I should never take stuff off the wish list, because it's things I want to go, I would like to have one of these new, I have a digital ham radio, but I'd like to have one of these other ones. And this is not a bad price for this one, but like I said, if you're buying a ham radio, by the way, I watch Twit TV and the Padre or whatever, and he's done a whole thing. This is really neat. This is really, you know, you put these little seeds in there or little plants in this thing. Appears a light and whatever, and you put the water in or what, and it automatically waters it. It automatically and puts the plant food in it, you know, automatically. And the amount of light on and off and whatever. And of course, they have a more expensive. They have a more expensive one, bigger. I don't see it here, but maybe it's down here, you know how they do. But this is really, really neat. But my cat would be jumping up, no matter where I put it, the cat would be jumping up and eating it. Back to wish list. How long have I been doing this? 48 minutes. I think we'll just make this an hour. It's already 3.8 gigabytes. How long do you think it's going to? We've got 100 gigabytes service now from Charter, but it's only 5 up. AT&T has out on the street put in 1 gigabyte fiber optics, but they haven't brought it into this apartment complex, but they dug up and put their boxes in. And just a few hundred feet from me is a fire station, Fort Worth Fire Station, and they hooked them up. So they've got 1 gigabyte up and 1 gigabyte down. And that's what I want. And luckily, my grandson pays for the internet service here, so he's ready and willing to pay for the service. By the way, he's been doing his interviews for the company that he works for. He's been an assistant manager and I forget what they call it, you know, whatever for. And then the company, because they're doing so, things are going on with that company. But then they've been doing the interviews with him for being manager at another store. and it would be probably double the money if he gets the, but it's further, it's really too far from here for, you know, we don't have a car. He doesn't have a driver's license. I told him, tried to get him to get a driver's license. Hillary, his mother, came from Sweden. Been here about a year. She didn't intend to stay that long, but she's been helping with some problems here. And the cat problem taken, solving the cat problem for, feral cat problem for Fort Worth. Fort Worth was doing free neutering, and they didn't have the manpower and the money for the animal control department, and so they stopped doing that, and Hillary had to end up. But if my grandson Russell does get this job, he's going to have to, you'll have to get an apartment over in Irwin, Texas. We're in Fort Worth. He really couldn't commute. If he had a car, it'd still be kind of a, but with no car. So I don't know. If they don't give him double the money, which they have in the past, if they don't do that, then I don't think he'll take the new manager's position. But if they do give him double the money, I would move over there and get an apartment over there, but I'm just too tired to move, and I really don't have the money to move to do, you know, to pay 2 months' rent and to give a deposit and pay for moving, and I can't hardly do much now physically. So he may be moving. You'll have to find a place over there. Anyway, how much are we? Okay, 52 minutes is long enough. I hope this was entertaining and interesting, and I hope you learned something. And I need to start doing live. You know, next month, November, and I did this back a few months ago, if you remember, I said I was going to do a video a day. And I think I did less than 15. I think I might have done 14 for the month. But starting November, starting here in a few days, I am going to try to do in November a video a day, and maybe I'll try to do live streaming video. So let me know what you like and you don't like. And I thank you very much for watching.